It's just crazy. What is up, guys? Welcome back to Scrap Mechanic. In the last episode, we checked out some awesome creations like the AT-AT. In today's video, we've got even more awesome creations that I want to take a look at. And man, some of the things that people have made just absolutely astound me. Like, I don't even understand how you even think up these things, let alone make them. So today's episode features some crazy creations. I don't even know where to begin. I don't know what to show first. So we've got a couple really awesome things. I'm actually gonna have to switch worlds for one of them. But we've got a centipede, which is this thing by Eric. We've got a massive passenger jet. This insane bipedal walker thing, which I don't even know how this is working. Oh, it looks like sensors maybe. This beast mech thing, which is awesome, and the beast warship, which is made by the same guy. So I thought today we would start off with the centipede and check this thing out and see what it's like. Now, we've seen a couple of things like this in the past, but we haven't, I don't think we've seen something like this yet. I know I haven't actually used anything like this, and so I'm interested to see what the thing is like. I got it facing the wrong way. Interested to see what this thing is like, because I think this thing's going to be pretty fun to use. Oh, there's the seat. I was like, where's the seat at? So, as you can see, it has multiple parts of the body. It's because it can flex, which is really cool. And then, you guessed it, these legs move. So, you can actually move the thing, and it will move with where you control. Now, the only question I have is, how does this thing... It's actually pretty stable. It's a lot slower than some of the other ones I've seen, but it moves really well, actually. Although, you kind of have to wiggle it if you want to just gently adjust the thing. That noise is really, really, like, loud in my ear. I'm turning the volume down. So, how does it go? Does it go up over things well? Can it crawl up it? Crawl over it? It cannot. So what about, how does it do if we put it like going up a mountainside or something? Can it climb up a mountain? I mean, I think it would, I would imagine that it would, because I would think that the weight would help it out. And the flexing of it. Oh no, look at that. I did not expect it to do that, but I mean, it kind of makes sense because look at, I mean, how the thing is set up. It's got, oh, now it's like really, now I broke it. It's got a, like, hinge. It's got a hinge in between each one. So it's not actually controlled by anything, and so then if it moves like that, it kind of gets offset. So, unfortunately, we cannot do that, which kind of stinks. But the thing actually walks really well for what it does. And one thing that I really like about it is the fact that there's not just one arm that's spinning. It's not like one part of the arm that's spinning. It's like two different things for each one. So that's kind of a cool, unique take on it. The one I think I've seen was Blitz's. That was really fast. Like one of the ones, I should say. It was really, really fast. But I don't know if you even call it a centipede. It looked totally different. So let's check out Beast Warship. We're going to actually have to move, I think. Let's find a stationary platform thing and resume once we're there. Okay, so I didn't find a platform, but I found a nice open area that should give us enough room to take off, because I think this thing can fly straight up. So it's by Bearded Beast. How it works, warship features an auto-stabilizing gyroscope, big guns, and a troop deployment area. If you tilt too much, the creation will stabilize on its own. That's insane. This feature makes it much easier to control. That is amazing, because I suck at flying things. Anyway, so we've got a main seat, we've got a turret control seat, and we got a door control seat, which is interesting. So fly, turn on and off main engines is 4, fly up is 2, 1 and 3 is turn left and right, and then W's go forward. So 4, 2, and 1 and 3. Let's do it. Whew! Okay, so that's front, so we're gonna have to turn that around. There we go. Okay, so it comes down, doors open up. Let's take a look at this thing. Holy crap. This thing is massive. Oh, I love this cockpit. Dude. Absolutely incredible. This is crazy. Wow, I'm so just absolutely stunned by this. Nice, like, seating in here. Nice back door. Wow, this thing is really nice. It's crazy, actually, on the FPS. It's not too bad. Maybe it helps with those things that are, like, down in the back there. The FPS is totally fine. This is shocking. Oh. Oh, that's awesome. How do I get in? okay, we're gonna have to pick it back up. Dude, that is sweet, man. That it opens like that. Look at that. Sliding doors are sweet. So not only does it go back, but it flips around. Oh, it's the switch that's doing it. Right? The switch is switching around? Yeah. The switch turns around. That's very clever. That I haven't seen that yet. Or, I mean, I haven't checked how many creations, but I haven't even thought of that. Dude, this cockpit is insanely awesome. Okay, so what was it again? 4 is main engines. Oh. Let's close the doors. Oh, wow, I got it right? In the right seat? Oh, that's a back door. 3 is side. 4 is that door. That's so cool, man. And this was the turret control seat. Dude. I cannot believe this ship is insane. All right, here we go. Let's go into... Dude, this is great, man. Okay, so we've got 4 main engines. Wait, no. What is fly up? 2. 2 is fly up. Whoa, dude, this thing is so stable. Is that the gyroscope thing right there? Fly forward is W. This thing is incredibly smooth. Let's drop it right on the mat, on the pad. We almost did it. I'm not the greatest pilot, but man, oh man, this thing makes it easy to control. I'm just blown away by this thing. Absolutely blown away. It's so ridiculously easy to control. Yeah, look at that. Beautiful. I literally cannot believe how easy it is to control this thing. I mean, barely anything in terms of control. This is an amazing creation. So we just cut the... Ah! Good thing the thing is made out of like some like insane alien alloy. Dude. Just incredible. This thing's just crazy. Wow! Wow! This ship is so good! I can't believe this thing. You guys have to tell me what you think of this thing. This is probably one of the best crafts I've ever flown in this game. Wow. That is just shockingly good. And that cockpit is just something of like a dream, man. That cockpit is awesome. Okay, let's go ahead and put this thing down. And now I really want to see this walker. This thing, we're going to check that mech out last, I think. But I think out of everything, this walker is like the craziest thing. Like, I don't even know how he has this thing set up. Watch this thing. Yeah, it's the sensor. Look at it. It's like self-balanced. It never tips over. Watch this thing. Watch how fast this thing is. It never tips over. It's just crazy. I've never seen half, like, anything act like these creations we're checking out today. This thing is insane, man! Sensor in the front. It's such a simple design, too. I mean, look at, in terms of what it does. Sensor. We got sensor there. So it's always being activated. We've got several different things of control in terms of like the rotation of the legs and stuff. And then just some suspension glitches, I think. This thing's awesome, man. This is probably one of my favorite creations ever. And guys, I think I found the best rock climber that you can possibly make in game right here. Let's really put it to the test here. Look at how fast it is. Let's really put this thing to the test right now. Is it capable of going up this rock? Nope. It almost had it. Maybe it just kind of takes a little bit of like jerking the... No. Never mind. It can't really climb up rocks and stuff, but man, oh man, this thing gets around. It doesn't fall over. There's no way to fall over. Playing music. If we had I want to have like a straightaway and just see how fast this thing actually can get. Cause it looks like it's just incredibly fast. Here we go. This thing's awesome. Guys, you guys need to get this from the workshop. This is probably one of my favorite creations ever. Oh my gosh! I feel like a little kid on Christmas. Just how like awesome how like this is like a gift to the scrap mechanic community right here. It's so derpy looking, but it works so well. Oh, I thought for a second there it was gonna fall over. It just never does. It just never falls over. I mean, look, you can do like complete 360s with this butt touching the ground. And it just always rights itself. Wow. Absolutely impressive. Holy smokes. What a great creation. Wow. Actually, let's go back over here to this open area and take a look at that plane. Because it doesn't fly from what I gather, but I guess it's really like well designed. So, I hope it doesn't lag my game. Probably will. That thing is insane. Who made that thing? Lord Lima Bean. Dude. Props to you. That is an amazing creation. Just absolutely amazing. Holy crap! You want to talk about massive? It's all made out of metal. That could be one reason why it doesn't fly. Wow. There's a door there. Dude, these creations. I love the workshop. This is great. It's a cargo bay. That's awesome. Is there another cargo bay entrance? There is. So where is the way to get into this thing? I want to see the inside. I want to see the middle of it. Switch is not connected to anything. How do we have to build to get up to it? I'll probably have to build. Get up on this lift. Open sesame. Oh no! Let's take a look inside. All right. Okay, so we've got a nice sink here. This is like, you know, stewardesses are gonna get some stuff and bring it back to you. Oh my gosh! Lavatory, the bathroom. Oh, there's another one. Maybe. Are you connected to anything? Why you no work? Okay, bathroom doesn't work. We've got so many seats in this place. If you're sitting in an exit seat, holy smokes. So it doesn't fly, but it does. Whoa. Oh, I knew that was gonna happen. Okay, good thing for that. Is there a way to get down to the cargo bay? That would be kind of cool. Doesn't look like it. That doesn't look like it. Maybe there's one up here and I missed it. That bipedal walker, though. Oh my gosh. He's insane. Okay, here's the pilot area. Alright, let's see. What do we got here? Taxi. Oh, the wheels raise. I wonder if he's planning on making this thing fly or... Oh, we broke it. It's too dang heavy to be doing that. Oh no. Okay, get out. Whew. How do I get out? Put it down out there. Oh, I guess the wings. Out on the wings? Yes. So we broke the thing because it's too freaking massive. It doesn't fit. Wow. Thing is sweet though. I mean, it's just absolutely massive. Okay, so where was that? Okay, let's go over here to flat ground and check out that mech, because I guess the mech is made by the same guy who made that ship, and that ship is insane, and this mech looks really good too. But I guess the thing with this mech is that it doesn't walk as well. It just kind of shuffles. But just the absolute sheer creation of the thing is... I mean, I've seen some mechs and they look great, you know. But like this thing actually looks like a mech, like a robot, legitimate robot. It's invisible, apparently. What the heck? What? Weird, why was it doing that? Okay, let's take it back here. Here it is, man. Look at this thing. Wow. Talk about good design. Oh, and it flies. Forgot about that. Thing actually flies. Okay, so we need to build a nice little derp ladder. Get up there. Come on, just let me stack it straight up. Oh, these are the days. Remember back in the day when we had to do this? Ah, don't overshoot it! I almost overshot it. Okay, so, shoot, I don't know. Remember the gun. Oh, this is one. Does the gun. Two is like the shooting. Like, imagine that's the gun that actually shoots. It's kind of cool because there's two different parts to it. One's going one way and the other one's going another way. Because there's two wheels. Oh yeah, 3 and 5 walk. 4 closes that. Look at this. Here's the cool thing. Look, check this out. Look at that. It's like an actual cockpit that you can actually look at and stuff. Like, that's just amazing. That's cool. So 4 does that. 3 and 5 walk. 6... What did 6 do? Oh, 6 is the claw. So A and D rotate the arms, actually. So if we do 1 and... Yeah, there we go. So you can actually move the claws and move the arms. And then we can raise that and So look, it opens and closes. I want to try grabbing something with that. I bet you can. Such a simple design, but it's so well done. That's insane. Okay, so W actually flies it. 3 and 5 walks. Ah! Yeah, baby, limbo! Limbo! This is one thing he kind of talked about. Was tapping 3 and 5. So, I failed. That's the only thing, is like, you kind of have to get the walking down. Oh, crap. I gotta build another one of these things. Whatever, we're gonna do it. Should build like an actual like ramp going up to it or something. So I don't have to do this every single time. I wanna see it walk and then I wanna fly it. Alright, so here we go. Close it. Okay, 3 and 5. That's literally how it walks. Baby steps. Remove the HUD. So, I mean, it doesn't really walk. It kind of just shuffles, you know, like that. And moonwalk it, baby. Yeah, that's what you have to do if it starts tilting back like that. So you can't take long walks, long strides. No! Okay, let's fly it. Face planted! Alright. Fly this thing. Okay. Well, I obviously am horrible at flying this thing. And now I have to build another thing going up there. Okay, one last time and then we're gonna fly the thing. One more ladder up. Take it off the lift. And we're flying it this time. So apparently it does fly. But he's working on making it fly better. Alright, here we go. This is kind of what it does. So given the fact that it has the weight that it does, it just kind of hovers there. So, but it, oh, there it goes, taking off. But now we're gonna crash. So, I mean, it kind of flies, but it kind of doesn't. But still, really, really cool, nonetheless. And definitely better than anything I could ever make. So, you know, props to this guy. Guys, I have to load up the Bipedal Walker one more time. Because the thing is just crazy. Like, honestly, this is like one of my favorite creations I think I've ever seen in this game. It's so funny. It's so derpy, man. Well, guys, thank you so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed this episode. Check out these things in the workshop because they are freaking awesome. They're like gifts to us in this game. Hope you guys enjoy the video. If you did, click that thumbs up button below and feel free to subscribe if you guys are new to the channel. Be on the lookout for more scrap mechanic videos because I plan on showing off things even more now that the workshop... Even more now that the workshop's in because these creations are just insane, and I'm having a great time checking them out. So thank you guys so much for watching. See you in the next one.